Nearly 300 homeless people were living on the streets of Kakaako. Today, we learned that number has gone down slightly, but there's still more work to be done. Brent Ramadna has been following this issue and joins us with more. Brent?
Joe, I checked with the governor's coordinator on homelessness today, and he tells me 10% of the homeless population in Kakaako are now in shelters, and they expect that number to go up.
At last count, the state said there were 293 people living in the Kakaako homeless encampment, and the goal is to help them all find shelter. But how are things going?
I think it's, you know, good that we're seeing some positive signs.
Optimism from the governor's newly appointed coordinator on homelessness as he talked about recently placing 28 people from the Kakaako homeless encampment into shelters.
So I think it's pretty significant that 10% of the population has been able to move, you know, off the street, including families with young children, and that they're now in shelter.
It's a small step towards a bigger goal, but there are still hundreds of people that still need shelter. Morshige says it's a slow process that can't be rushed.
We've been able to temporarily hold off some of the enforcements, which have allowed providers the time to be able to go in, work with families, and move them off the streets as quickly as they can.
But is moving people out of Kakaako the solution or just a quick fix? I spoke with Kimo Carvalho with the Institute for Human Services for his thoughts.
So we do a great job moving people out of homelessness. The problem is people falling in.
He says the work being done in Kakaako is helping, but more can be done to address homelessness as a whole.
There's a lot of factors that are contributing to homelessness, so we need to prevent more people from falling into homelessness by fixing some of these cracks in the systems. By doing that, then we're able to really kind of at the same time move people out of the system and actually see less homeless on the streets.
And I'm told the governor's team has identified 5 state-owned portable buildings that can be used to provide temporary shelters for homeless families. We'll stay on top of this to bring you the latest developments. Brent Ramadna, KHON 2 News.